Okay, we good here? You fighters receive your instructions in the dressing room. Obey my commands at all times, and above all, protect yourself at all times. Touch him up and come out.
We've seen many times that for these tough, largely unknown fighters out of Mexico, success is a matter of getting the opportunity. Here's an opportunity, but it comes against Mikey Garcia, a blue chip prospect and now contender out of one of the best gyms in boxing.
Guzman was able to take this fight on 3 days' notice because he was scheduled to fight on a card in Mexico next Saturday night. So he's been in the gym, ready to go. His father is a former professional fighter who's in his corner. And Guzman in the black and gold. Garcia in the dark brown and silver. Roy, what do you look for early for Garcia? He's fighting an opponent that he had absolutely no time to prepare for.
Yeah, well, Garcia is a smart guy. He's in a gym full of great fighters, so there's nothing that this guy can offer that he hasn't seen. So far, you see Guzman starting out with a great jab, which is creating distance for him, and Garcia is just trying to feel him out to figure out how to put that mean right hand on his chin.
One thing, it's not that he hasn't seen, but he's probably not used to, is a guy with a several inches of height on him, Roy, at this weight.
Yeah, this is a good thing for Guzman. However, we also know that he's been out, and we know that Garcia packs a mean punch, so we'll have to see who takes advantage of what situation first.
Guzman got knocked out March the 6th of last year in Mexico in the first round against Carlos Cardenas. Guzman actually dropped Cardenas in that first round, and then he said, I got careless, thought it was easy, got caught with the right hand. He must always concentrate, but it was a learning experience for me. I'll never do that again.
Well, good thing here is Garcia's already felt Guzman's power. Guzman does not know what lies in that right-hand glove of Garcia yet.
Here's a huge step up in class for Guzman. Stiff jab from Garcia.
Just watching Guzman handle himself, you can see that he can handle himself.
And you can tell that he comes from a family of boxers. Just by the way he handles himself.
Guzman, you mean?
Yes.
What do you mean specifically?
Well, he's very calm. He's very patient here, and he knows he's fighting a big fighter, and he's landing some great punches on Garcia early. This usually doesn't happen to Garcia.
I mentioned that Guzman's father was a fighter. He actually fought on the undercard of a Julio Cesar Chavez fight.
I believe he may have hurt Garcia with that left hook just now.
Well, you know what I liked? Garcia kept that right hand tight, and when he tried to follow up with another left hook, Guzman did, Garcia picked it off.
Well, you know, Garcia is an excellent, confident defensive fighter. He doesn't go out and rush things. He waits. He allows his time, his openings to come, and then he takes advantage.
So funny because some of that frustrates his father and sometimes even his brother a little bit because of the temperament of their gym. But as Mikey said, hey, I got to be me. Well, I'm the one in there.
Right now, I think it's frustrating him a little bit even because he can't land nothing big without getting caught with something big.
Guys, this first round with some high-level stuff.
Right hand and a left from Guzman, then a counter shot from Garcia. Time. End of round one.
No se descuide, okay? Breathe.
Be careless.
How are you doing?
Okay.
How do you feel?
Good?
You throw three punches, you know that. And you're being last. What's he at? No? Okay, but be careful then. Especially in closing the rounds. Don't be desperate. You're good, you felt it. You felt the strength? How'd you feel? Good? Okay.
Well, let's take a look at some of the action in round number one.
Right here you see Guzman come with a 1-2, followed by a counter left hook from Garcia that lands in the back of the neck. What an awkward place to get caught at.
So we begin round number two of the scheduled 10-round featherweight bout between Mikey Garcia and Rafael Guzman. Garcia, according to CompuBox, outlanded Guzman in the round 13-9. Guzman busier, though. He threw 38 more punches.
Like Guzman's jab, Roy, he's landing it from long range against Garcia.
Yeah, I like it. He's landing it from long range, but if you look at it, he's also putting a lot of weight on that front foot when he throws his jab.
Heavy jab?
Yes, and what will happen is, as the fight goes on, Mikey will try to trick him into throwing that jab and counter with a right hand.
The Garcia camp, brother Robert, one of his trainers, said that even in preparation for Miguel Beltran, who pulled out of this fight, boy, they weren't really training specific. They were just doing their own thing. So it really didn't matter that there's a different opponent because they weren't training specifically for any fighter. They were just trying to get better. Why would they take that? There's a good left hand by Garcia. Then he unloads with the right hand. Oh. Good right hand by Garcia after a left hand. Steps in with the right hand again. It's the power of Mikey Garcia.
And there's a cut on the right eye of Guzman now.
And Mikey Garcia is doing that on real pure boxing skill. He's a skillful enough fighter that against a guy with a longer reach and height, who can handle himself? Here it is early in the fight, second round, and Garcia's landing clean, hard shots flush on the face.
Roy, is that, as Garcia throws a left and then steps in with a right hand again, is that something that does happen during the course of one's career, that in preparation for a fight, they don't really go fighter-specific and just work on stuff on their own?
Yeah, because in Julio Cesar Chavez Jr.'s case tonight, you have guys that change up sometimes. They don't always fight the same. So it's best to get yourself prepared the best that you can be, and then whatever he brings, you can deal with it, especially if you're a complete fighter. And I think Mikey Garcia is definitely a complete fighter.
Bad cut over the right eye here of Guzman.
Guzman has been cut training on the bridge of his nose and his head, but never has sustained a cut to the eye like that. But he's got one here on the right eye in round two.
I like Garcia's defense. Keeps that right hand high, the chin tucked, elbows in.
I like his patience. He has a lot of patience. He didn't go out in the first round and just do anything just to land a punch. He took his time, waited until the openings came, and then he took advantage of it.
End of round number two. A very good round for Mikey Garcia.
Beautiful work. Bien, mijo.
How are you feeling? Good?
Good.
Son, I told you, from the last round, keep your hand, your right hand up. If you throw, you bring it back, he's going to catch you. You got to bring it back and work that shot to the cheek. You're good? Okay, I'm okay. You've got to jab him. And bring your knees down. Bend your knees. He's catching you over the top.
All right, let's take a look at a left hook coming up right here to the right eye of Guzman that caused the cut, right? There you go. So you saw the punch, and I confirmed in between rounds here with referee Wayne Hedgepath that the punch did cause the cut. So yeah, it's been ruled a punch.
Yeah, but worse than that left hook was, you saw him get hit with the same right hand two times in a row right there. That is not a good thing when you're fighting a power puncher like Garcia.
All right, let's check in with our unofficial ringside scorer, Harold Letterman.
Okay, Bob, well, I got it all even. I thought Rafael Guzman outworked Mikey Garcia in round number one. But in round number two, Mikey Garcia started coming with that straight right hand. I mean, do some real damage. Cut Guzman's eye and won that second round big, just like you said. 1-1, 19-19, all even so far.
Roy, you almost get the sense that as Guzman steps in with a combination, Garcia goes into protective mode. That in that second round, Garcia really sort of figured out the angles that he needs against the taller opponent and sort of an awkward guy.
Well, he figured out the distance. That was the main thing, getting the distance on his right hand. He figured out how to use that jab to get close enough and then bring the right hand straight down the pipe.
Although Mikey Garcia is not a blood and guts kind of fighter because he hasn't had to be so far, it's really a pleasure to watch him ply his craft here. Getting the upper hand, not just on athletic talent, but on real pure boxer puncher skills.
Max, where do you see, you know, Mikey Garcia right now in the landscape of the featherweights?
Stop. Watch your body behind your head. Stop holding.
Guzman caution for holding.
I think at featherweight, there's one outstanding talent that has separated himself from the pack. And that's, of course, Euryorkis Gamboa, the Cuban sensation. I think Mikey Garcia already fits in comfortably with everyone else. Already.
And he's just 23 years of age. Won't turn 24 until December the 15th.
Saw Salido upset Juan Manuel Lopez.
There's Garcia digging in with some power.
He found a mark with that right hand now. That's going to be bad for Guzman.
Guzman trying to keep him away with that jab.
That was Guzman's best weapon early with that long jab because it kept Mikey off guard and away from him with that straight right hand.
Hey, he threw 40 in the first round in which he had that good round. Even though he only landed three, Roy, the fact that he was throwing a lot of them worked to his advantage.
That's right. It made it more of a defensive punch.
Speaking of defense, Roy, I've noticed that since...
Right hand by Garcia. Right across the chin of Guzman.
Since the first round, Guzman's jab's been much less effective. Might be a moot point now.
10 seconds. Right and a left. Guzman trying to fight back. Garcia steps in with a right again. Time. End of round three.
Get it lower. Bend your knees. Lower a little bit.
Ahí te va, mijo. Está tranquilo.
Let's go, son. Relax.
Acá,
a turn.
Get the ribs. They're fucking, he's got long ribs, so let's work the body shot, right? Okay? When you throw the body, don't drop your right hand. Okay? When you go to the left of the body, don't drop it. Because he's throwing that hook. Muy bueno tu trabajo.
Very nice job.
Okay? Breathe.
Here we see Garcia starting to line him up with his jab and follow with a straight right hand right on the button. That was one. Then he came back once again right behind the jab with a straight right, bam, right down the pipe. You cannot allow him to land that punch that comfortably over and over again.
And according to CompuBox, Garcia, 22 of 38 as far as the connects. But, you know, the one thing Garcia did in that round that was really nice, Roy, he used his jab. He was 11 of 23 with his jab, according to CompuBox, and then 11 of 15 with his power shot. So the jab really set up the power shots for Garcia.
Yeah, they did. It did. And he started winning the jab battle against a taller guy. You don't often see that, but it always works in his favor when it does.
Left hand by Garcia, counter shot from Guzman.
I was going to ask, Roy, how has he kept taking the jab away? How has Garcia taken the jab away? Oh!
He's taking away with his own jab. He started jabbing first instead of letting Guzman. See like that? He's jabbing first now. Guzman's not jabbing first. Watch, see right there? Garcia leads with the jab first. Therefore, he's taking Guzman's jab away
from him. Guzman may be a little gun shy with his own jab because he keeps getting countered, as you mentioned, with right hands.
He can't seem to block the right hand for some reason. No defense at all.
And that's what gave Guzman the success, too, in the first round, was his doubling and tripling up his jab.
Exactly. It kept Garcia off of him, so now Garcia can get to him at will because he's not jabbing as much.
See, Guzman is a tough guy. Doesn't seem discouraged in spite of the shellacking he's taken the last couple rounds.
Not at all.
And he's not simply throwing caution to the wind. He's still trying to execute a game plan. It's just he's being outskilled.
Well, you know, he's one tough guy, as we told you the story about. Oh, walked right into a shot there from Garcia.
Four, the same right here.
Five, six.
Oh,
seven.
And he's not getting up. Just over a minute to go on the fourth. Wayne Hedgepath stops it.
That was a complete and very impressive performance from Mikey Garcia.
He landed 10 of 13 power shots in that fourth round and finishes off Guzman and gets knockout number 22 and win number 26.
let a guy consistently hit you over and over again with his best punch, that's usually going to happen.
Well, let's take a look at how Mikey Garcia finished him off in round number four.
When he came out with his jab, like we said earlier, he led with the jab, followed right behind with the right hand. He's been doing it all night for the last three or four rounds at least, and eventually it was going to get to him.
Another look at it.
Straight right hand, right off the jab. Just a basic 1-2 right down the pipe.
Second, fourth round stoppage in Garcia's career. I mean, he got the full shoulder and leverage behind that one, Roy.
He got everything into it because he knew that he knew he was going to land it. He's landed it several times before, two times back-to-back almost every time, so he knew he was going to land it.
You know, he might be only 23, but you can just see the way he boxes, Roy. He's got a very high boxing IQ. I mean, he breaks down his opponent mentally and physically, leading to the knockout. It's not just brute force.
Well, you got to remember that his brother was a world champion also.
Yeah.
His daddy was a world champion trainer. I mean, he's in the gym with some of the best fighters that are fighting right now to date. And he has to survive in the gym with these guys. So you know he has a high IQ or he wouldn't be where he is now.
All right, let's get the official time of the stoppage to Michael Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, the end comes at 1 minute 55 seconds of round number four. The winner by knockout victory, his record now still perfect, 26-0-22 by knockout. The fighting pride of Oxnard, Moreno Valley, California, Miguel Mikey Garcia.